Welcome back, Trans Theorists, to another episode of Fixing Transformers. And in today's, we're going to take a look at what happened to Optimus Prime's trailer in Transformers Dark of the Moon, and how we got it in the first place. So without further ado, let's jump right in. In the third installment of the former Transformers Cinematic Universe, Optimus Prime for the first time had a trailer in cinematic form, with the Bumblebee standalone film also later jumping onto this trend. But it's not like the trailer is for show, because it's a nod to Transformers Generation 1 since that incarnation of Optimus always had a trailer with him. But moving back onto Dark of the Moon, the trailer served a purpose, for it to transform into an armored weapons platform for Optimus when he was ambushed by Shockwave. And with this trailer, there's one huge misconception with it, and that misconception is the flight tech part of it. Most people believe that the whole trailer becomes Optimus Prime's flight tech, but in reality it's only a portion of the trailer. If you look at the top of the trailer when it's in the weapons platform mode, you can see at the top that there's two fins that are sticking out, with two boosters to accommodate them, along with a giant wing to the side. Now you could say that's all for show, since the Dark of the Moon Ultimate Optimus Prime combines with his trailer, and for the record, this look for Prime never happened in the film, making it totally inaccurate. But to reinforce this point, let's take a look at the new studio series Dark of the Moon Optimus Prime. And as you can see, the flight tech is a separate piece that connects to the trailer, just like in the film. But if that does not satisfy you, let's take a look at the fans wanted advanced weapons upgrade kit for Optimus Prime. And yet again, if you look at the back of the box, we can see the flight tech at the top, with the wings set aside. And to further push this point, we can see Optimus Prime's guns from his flight tech in the upgrade kit. And if we look closely in the Dark of the Moon film, we can clearly see them again in the weapons arsenal. But if you're still not satisfied with all this evidence, let's take a look at the weapons arsenal itself. In this shot, we can see that the arsenal is massive, and for the whole thing to fit onto Prime's back is not logically possible. So with that last nail in the coffin, I think we can conclude that his jetpack is a separate piece. But before we get into what happened to Prime's trailer, we first need to solve how did he get it in the first place. Well, if you watch my Stealth Force video, you will know the answer, and that would be Q. And to back this statement up, he was a scientist for the Autobots between the events of Revenge of the Fallen and Dark of the Moon. We saw that he gave the soldiers boomsticks and grapple gloves. He also gave Ironhide Heavy Iron 2.0 to serve as an upgrade from his Heavy Iron 1.0 that he also created to be used as replacements for the cannons he lost in Operation Firestorm. He also gave Sideswipe an upgrade by giving him two new blasters in Dark of the Moon, while previously in Revenge of the Fallen he only had one. And this is just the tip of the iceberg for what Q has done for the Autobots, and I'll be covering that more so in the next video. But if you take a look at what I've said, it connects the dots perfectly for him to be the only one that created Prime's trailer. And to put the icing on the cake, all of the other Autobots in Dark of the Moon besides Q were not scientists or engineers, besides the Wreckers. But since after their Autobot training in Diego Garcia, during the events between Transformers and Transformers Revenge of the Fallen, they were moved to the Kennedy Space Center at NASA to do maintenance on the Xanthium. Stated by a line that Charlotte Mearing says,
"You guys are the Wreckers, they take care of the Xanthium. We don't let them off the base much because they're assholes."
And with that, we can conclude that Wheeljack was the only scientist around that would have been able to create Optimus Prime's trailer. And if that all squared off, we can now move on to what happened to the trailer itself. And well, the first part of this question is very simple. During Optimus' rage, he uses flight tech from his trailer to crash and bash into many Decepticons. And if you paid attention closely, he sheds off his jetpack to have better mobility and speed. But now you could say trance. Could have Optimus Prime picked up his flight tech after his rage and use it again? Well, the answer to this is no. And here's why. If you look closely when the jetpack dismounts from Optimus's back, it exploded, causing the explosion to form outward, just before Optimus hits sideways. And this explosion would also take out the lives of Longhaul and his Decepticon protoform. But now for his guns, that's partly the same story. Since when he throws his guns off, they would eventually explode. Now if you don't believe me, take a look at this. Once Optimus throws off Gun A, it lands around here and causes this explosion, where the tiny Brawl drone would be flung into. And Gun B would land in front of this car, which is where Scrapper would eventually fall onto. And if you look at this shot, we can see part of the explosion Gun A created. And Gun B's explosion happens when Scrapper falls. But now you may be wondering, what's the point of all this? To throw away the capability of flight and some extra firing power. Well, as I explained before, it was all used to help kill part of the Decepticon army. And if you really think about it, this is all planned by Prime himself, as a coordinated attack. Because if you look at the way he threw off the jetpack, the connections from the pack to the guns detach, instead of taking the guns with it. And what I mean here is, if Prime just wanted to detach the jetpack, he would have let the guns go with it. But with what I've proved, this was just yet another crazy coordinated attack from Prime himself, since he knew after putting his jetpack in self-destruct mode, it would explode, helping the Autobots kill the Decepticons much easier. And for all the other explosions in the scene, I like to theorize that they came from camouflage pulse bombs that dropped when some of the protoforms saw Optimus coming for them. But now to answer part 2 of this question, where did the armory go? Well, the last time we ever saw the armory in Prime's trailer, in fact, was when Shockwave attacked. and with the help of his pet driller, detached the trailer, causing Optimus not being able to use it. But as we saw in Prime's Rage, since Prime still had his flight tech, then he would have been able to transform the trailer and take out his jetpack. So then, what happened to the armory? Well, I believe that he went back and looted it, taking the stuff that was most useful in the long run, which is proven by the fact that Optimus' heavy assault rifle is seen in the armory, and in Transformers Age of Extinction, as his primary weapon. But for the reason why he never took the armory back was because of two reasons. One being the fact that the first part of the trailer was now destroyed, so he wouldn't be able to haul it back to Nest. And two, the main reason. Once he heard word of Wheeljack's passing, he left the armory there as a sort of memorial to remember him by, where the other Autobots would bury Wheeljack's body, and mourn for him, Ironhide, and all that was lost that day. And just like that, that's what happened to Optimus Prime's beloved trailer in Transformers Dark of the Moon. If you enjoyed this theory into fixing Transformers collection, please give a like rating because it helped the channel a lot. And as always, this has been Trans Series, reminding you guys to never stop theorizing. Well, your car was soon regret.